from his main teacher Nafi', Mawla Ibn Umar, from Ibn Umar, from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Imam Malik also learned fiqh a lot from Rabi'at al-Ra'i, rahimahullah. Imam al-Shafi'i, he is a student of Imam Malik. But when he returned to Mecca, he started learning from Imam Muslim ibn Khalid al-Zinji, who was a student of Ata, a student of Ibn Abbas. So if you go into each school of thought, you will see the foundation, the fountain, the manba' is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I did not mention the madhab of Az-Zuhri rahimahullah, or his student Al-Awza'i, which is from Mu'ad ibn Jabal, from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or madhab Al-Thawri, which was in Kufa, or madhab Al-Layth ibn Sa'd rahimahullah. But one thing which is common, they end up to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One other thing, in all these four schools of thought, there is no difference in halal and haram. In fact, cannot be. Otherwise, our deen is not protected. The only difference you will find out is in sunan, in nawafil, in mustahabbat, in mandubat, in fara'id, in halal, in haram. There is no difference. In fact, cannot be. So for a mufti, for a alim, he should learn all these madahid, especially living here in US. Now, what is Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, who is al-mufti and how he should be? Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said al-mufti المخبر بحكم الله تعالى لمعرفته بدليله. Imam al-Shatibi said المخبر عن الله بحكمه. Who is Mufti? The one who tells us about the commands of Allah, knowing all the references, all the evidence. Shatibi rahimahullah, he said Mufti is the trustee of Allah's command. And he also said المتمكن من معرفة أحكام الوقائع شرعا بالدليل مع حفظه لأكثر الفقه. The one who has really vast knowledge about the أحكام of halal and haram, and he memorized more of the opinions. Now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to sum it up very quickly. So Mufti today would be again a person who has learned the knowledge from a alim or from some institution. One of the drawbacks we have in this age, Muslims, that everyone starts giving fatawa. You ask anyone, any issue of deen, they will reply. No matter they know or not, they will tell you their opinion. And some even, subhanAllah, they have this jur'ah, they would say, whatever I said is the truth. The only truth is whatever I said. Wal'iyadu billah. While Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ إِنْتِزَاعًا يَنْتَزِعُهُ مِنْ صُدُورِ الرِّجَالِ وَلَكِنْ يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ بِقَبْضِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Almighty Allah, do not snatch the knowledge from your chest, from your heart, or from your mind. Allah the Almighty is going to take it away by the death of ulama. فَإِذَا لَمْ يَبْقَ عَالِمٍ اتَّخَذَ النَّاسُ رُؤُوسًا جُهَالٍ. When ulama will be gone, people will take ulama or a'imma who are juhal, ignorant. فَسُئِلُوا فَأَفْتُوا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. When they will be asked, they give fatwa without any stand, any base, any knowledge. فَضَلُّوا وَأَضَلُّوا. They mislead and they are misled by themselves. مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. So a alim must follow Quran, Sunnah, madhahib al-salaf, and must be again having that ijaza from some alim that he can give fatwa. He is a mufti now, ready to give fatwa, or some institution, some university of Muslims who ask him that, yes, you are now ready, you have the degree to give fatwa. Yet, subhanallah, let me quote here very briefly about some salaf, our righteous ancestors, and how they were when it comes to ifta, to give fatwa. Sayyidina Bara ibn Azib radiallahu anhu, he said, and he is a young sahabi, young companion among the companions of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ 300 مِنْ أَصْحَابِ بَدْرٍ مَا فِيهِمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا وَهُوَ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يَكْفِيَهُ صَاحِبَهُ الْفُتْيَا. I have seen 300 from the people of Badr. They are the most senior among the companions of Sahaba. And he said, anyone asked fatwa? He was loving that others should answer, not him. That I cannot bear this burden to give a fatwa in Deen Allah and be responsible before Allah. Imam Ibn Abi Layla, rahimahullah, he said, أَدْرَكْتُ 20 و100 من الْأَنصَارِ من أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يُسْأَلُ أَحَدُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَسْأَلَةِ فَيَرُدَّهَا هَذَا إِلَى هَذَا وَهَذَا إِلَى هَذَا حَتَّى تَرْجِعَ إِلَى الْأَوَّلِ. He said, I have seen 120 from the Ashab of Rasulullah, from the companions of Rasulullah, from Ansar. Anyone was asked any issue, any mas'ala, he used to refer it to his friend. You answer. Until it comes back to the first ones. They were that much afraid of giving fatwa. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, the one about whom Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أراد أن يقرأ القرآن غضا كما أنزل فليقرأه على قراءة ابن أم عبد. You want to recite and receive Quran as fresh as it is revealed, learn it from Ibn Umm Abd, from Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. Learn it from him. He and Ibn Abbas, Habr al-Umma radiallahu anhuma, they said, من أفتى الناس في كل ما يسألونه في كل ما يسألونه عنه فهو جاهل أو مجنون. If a person start giving fatwa, and they are talking about ulama, by the way, and he start giving fatwa about each and everything, he's inquired, such person either jahil or crazy. Imam al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, the one who grew up in the house of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through Ummu Salama and other wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Imam al-Sha'bi, he said, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيُفْتِي فِي الْمَسْأَلَةِ لَوْ وَرَدَتْ عَلَىٰ عُمَرْ لَجَمَعَ لَهَا أَهْلَ بَدْرِ. That among us you people give fatwa in issue, if that issue comes to Umar, he would gather all the people of Badr to discuss it before giving any fatwa or any verdict. And Ibn Uyayna, Sufyan ibn Uyayna, and Suhnun, the founder of Maliki school of thought, the one who wrote Al-Mudawwina, which is the base of Maliki school of thought, he said, أَجْسَرُ النَّاسِ عَلَى الْفُتْيَا أَقَلُّهُمْ عِلْمًا. The one who give more fatawa, they have less knowledge. It indicates that they have less knowledge. And the quotation on this is a lot. I cannot go through them all. I'll end up here in one thing. And this is my request and advice, starting from myself and ulama and mashayikh sitting here, that one thing alim require. And that is must. Without it, ulama are in danger. Those who are giving fatwa, they are in danger. That one thing we call it ikhlas. You have to have that before giving any fatwa. If a mufti or alim is not mukhlas, la samahallah, he is in danger. And I'll again quote few ahadith only out of many Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And this is narrated by Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him. من تعلم علما مما يبتغى به وجه الله لا يتعلمه إلا ليصيب به عرضا من الدنيا لم يجد عرف الجنة يوم القيامة. قال أبو هريرة يعني ريحها. Whoever seek knowledge, those knowledge which should be for the sake of Allah, and he seeks it for the sake of dunya or any arad, anything of dunya, such person will never have a smell of Jannah. In another narration, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is by Ka'b ibn Malik, من طلب العلم ليجاري به العلماء أو ليماري به السفهاء ويصرف به وجوه الناس إليه أدخله الله النار. Whoever seeks the knowledge to compete with ulama or to show his knowledge that common people would admire him and let people look at him as a alim, such person Almighty Allah will let him end up into hellfire. May Allah secure us from it. Ameen. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, كيف بكم إذا لبستكم فتنة. How you would be when you will be covered in the turmoil, in a fitna, in a test. يربو فيها الصغير ويهرم فيها الكبير وتتخذ سنة فإن غيرت يوما قيل هذا منكر. That this turmoil, in it you will see those who are small in your eyes big, those who are big in your eyes small, and you will see new customs, invented one, which are out of Islam, away from it. And if someone says, no, it's wrong, people will jump at him that, no, you are wrong. قِيلَ وَمَتَى ذَلِكَ. And Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu was asked when this will be. قال إذا قلت أمناؤكم وكثرت أمراؤكم وقلت فقهاؤكم وكثرت قراؤكم وتفقه لغير الدين والتمست الدنيا بعمل الآخرة. He said this would be when those whom you trust will be less. But those who want authority and rule would be a lot. Those who are really scholars, fuqaha, will be less. But those who want to be admired in recitation, in ilm, there will be a lot. And deen will be seek, not for the sake of Allah. And people will make dunya preferred over akhirah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, and I would like to share this dua with you. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa' wa min qalbin la yakhsha' wa min nafsin la tashba' wa min da'watin la yustajabu laha. O Allah, I seek your refuge from that knowledge which won't benefit me in dunya and akhirah, from that heart which is not fearing you, from that soul which is never filled, from that dua which is not answered. And in the end, I would like to request you, if I committed any mistake, please correct me. And I seek Allah's forgiveness if I committed any mistake. May Allah the Almighty grant us knowledge. May Allah the Almighty allow us to act upon knowledge. As Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also taught us, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'a wa amalan mutaqabbala wa du'aan mustajaba wa rizqan wasi'a. O Allah, I seek from you a knowledge which is beneficial. I seek from you to act upon that knowledge. I seek that dua which is always answered, and I seek that rizq which is vast and halal, inshaAllah ta'ala. May Allah the Almighty keep me and keep us all, inshaAllah, on guidance. Amen. Allahumma ahdina wahdi bina. Jazakumullah khairan jazak.
Inshallah, we open the floor for question and answer session for about 10 to 15 minutes max. Yes. And I would like to start with myself, if it's possible. My assumption that Sheikh Bilal is more advanced in the school of Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh. And what do you say concerning a statement, I'm not saying it's right or true, but that Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh says that the muskir is only from certain things, doesn't matter if cause or not, these things which is that the Prophet had mentioned, like the grapes and dates and barley. So if we make anything which will cause intoxication, but out of this types is acceptable. Can you clarify this issue, please?
This is the issue of Nabeez, which you are talking about, Shaykh. It is rejected by all ulama, even Fuqaha Hanafiya themselves. There are a lot of opinions of Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah. It is not considered as al-fiqh al-Hanafi. And anything very simple, which and all imams, including Imam al-Arba'a, among our righteous ancestors, they have one thing in common, and they said it very out loud. If any of my opinion conflict with the opinion of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I did not know it, and you knew it and realize it through my opinion to the wall. This is obvious because our fountain, our actual foundation is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we are asked to follow him. So if someone is claiming to be Shafi'i or Hanafi and thinks I'm following Imam Shafi'i or Imam Abu Hanifa instead of Prophet of Allah, such person went out of Islam. Because I have to follow Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi.
But do you know, to your knowledge, is this in the fiqh of Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi? I'm not asking about the Hanafiya school, I'm talking about...
Yes, Abu Hanifa rahimahullah was in favor of Nabiz, yes.
Okay. Although
and
it can
succeed. And he says that over 70 Sahaba, they made it halal, so how I could call it haram?
Can you explain Nabiz to the people?
So I was trying to avoid, but Sheikh brought it this up. This is a very... I was trying to avoid even explaining Nabiz. Nabiz is the liquor which made out of dates. They call it Nabiz. And it becomes liquor, it becomes wine. After 3 days, if you put dates in water,
dry dates,
yes, in water, after 3 days, that water turns into muskir, intoxicated. And according to all, even Hanafi, Fuqaha and Ulama, it's haram. Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, his opinion is not valid on this one. Okay. Even among Hanafi ulama.
Jazakallah khair. Second question we heard about...
Why? Sorry, Shaykh.
Sorry.
Because we have a very clear hadith.
We have hadith, yes.
Kullu khamrin.
Naam.
Jazakallah khair.
I understand because this, you said it that all the school of thoughts about is not difference of opinion in what's in haram. So this was the issue that I was trying to clear. We have a great big turban had came here to America, and he made a fatwa concerning usury. And if I'm not mistaken, that he said that Imam Abi Hanifa, may Allah send mercy in his soul and forgive us and him. That since you are in a kafir country is okay. And he attributed this, if I'm not mistaken, to the Hanafi school. What he's saying?
Not at all.
Okay.
Again, what is haram from Quran, from Sunnah, no alim would even dare to say no, it's halal. Here, again, Abu Hanifa rahimahullah has a benefit of doubt, and he explained that I have seen 70 ashab, or their opinion, who call it halal for Nabi. But usually, subhanAllah,
yeah, of course, we have the statement in Quran Hadith, it comes first, but am I try to make sure, is these things actually in the school of thoughts?
Never.
Of,
never.
But the Nabi is?
Yes.
Okay. Jazakallah khair. Thank you for your patience with me.
Yes, sir. Yes, brother.
About we live in America, all of us here, and we buy cars, we buy houses, we buy everything else, and they always have an interest in it, 1%, 2%, and you know, most of us don't have the money to come up with 10,000 for a car, 15, and a lot of the brothers here ask about the same question all the time.
Jazakallah khair. Try to buy cars, those who have 0% interest. Now that we have that. And even those who have, subhanAllah, interest, you go there, tell them you are Muslim, you don't want interest, they will remove you from that. SubhanAllah. The problem, you want to ask. Okay. The problem is we even are not reluctant to ask or to fight with haram. We are ready to eat haram, thinking that, okay, I'm living in, as Sheikh said, Bilad al-Kufar, so okay, fine. While subhanAllah, you will see Yahud here from the beginning. They have the meat of kosher. From the beginning, subhanAllah, they fought for that. And we being Muslims, we just run away. It's fine. I don't have other option. Let me do it. Why, subhanAllah? First, at least try your best. If not, then we will come into a situation, okay, now all the doors are closed in front of me, now what should I do? Right now we don't have that situation.
Sure. Alhamdulillah. It's 2% okay, Sheikh? It's 2% is okay?
How is it? Sir?
Only 2%.
2%?
Is it okay?
Why?
Is it 2% usury is okay? Not 7, not 2, 14.
Now, do you want me to answer in your tone? Is a little bit of, subhanAllah, poison is okay, Sheikh, in your food? Or my food?
For me, not even the smell of it.
Jazakallah khair. May Allah reward you, Sheikh. Jazakallah khair. Shakirallahu lakum.
Inshallah.
Hadir. Yes, brother, inshallah, then we'll come to sisters.
Inshallah, I don't say, this is not a question, it's just a commentary for the question about the usury. The problem is not about the river. The problem is trying to run away from the law. Uh-huh. That's why we have many fatwa. The problem we have many fatwa about that. Because people now are burdening to get out from the implementing the law. That's number one. Number two, why you go to buy the car you can afford? Because when you fall into the river, because you go to buy something you like, it's not something you need. If you need the car, you need something to move you from point A to B. $2,000 to $3,000, which you have, that's what I'm getting, inshallah.
May Allah reward you, Sheikh. May Allah reward you. For house mortgage, there was a fatwa, and people use that actually a lot for a reference for what the brother said. To buy a house. Dar al-Ifta, they have given this fatwa, this is a long time, in 80s I believe, in early 80s, that you may buy a house with mortgage. But there was a clause, if you don't have alternate at all. Yes. But that was like, as I said, still, I hope, inshallah, we have Islamic banks and Islamic organization who could support. We start having, alhamdulillah, few, but we need to have more, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, which are free from interest and riba, bi-idhnillah.
Have you tried ever to call this Islamic banks and see how they tell you, what they talk to you? I tried that. They said go to 2-3 mortgages and tell us what they tell you. Then if they give you like for the house 80,000, we'll sell it to you for 90,000. So they just did, actually they just turned it
worse,
around
worse.
And make
true.
It yes
true
because I
but
tried.
That's why I said houses are into that fatwa, yes, because still we don't have organizations or Islamic banks purely which is free from interest except 2 or 3 all over the United States.
I checked that not just for me, for some of the brothers too, because even a car, they tell you how much is a car. If it's 10,000, they said, okay, we'll give you 12,000. You pay us 12,000. It's not riba, but we make it out of your payments. So actually, it's the same thing, like what they add in whatever the 2% or 1%, and they just add it to the principal, and they're telling you, we're not charging you anything.
Uh-huh.
So it's just the same exact thing.
Yes, I mean. He said that if you have an issue, and you go to ask an imam about the solution for that issue, believe me, you will find someone providing you with the correct, you know, solution for that issue, the shari, okay, or the religious opinion about this. And if you do not like this, you will go and search about someone else, trying to issue a fatwa that meets your own desire. That meets, as brother said, that meets your own needs. And you will find that person. That's why we have multi, as you said, mufti around the world. Particularly here in US. Anyone, everyone acts as a mufti, even if he does not have knowledge about the deen. Okay? And I went through many of this. When you tell people about the Shari ruling, they tell you this is not, you know, this does not meet or fit our needs.
Hmm.
So get us another something, you know, that fits our needs. Okay? So that's, as you said, this is something that, you know, causes us the distraction of the deen. Okay?
Also, those who are seeking fatwa, unfortunately, I have seen this, Jazakallah Khair, Brother Jum'ah. We back in Pakistan, and most of people, they are coming to find some excuse how to run away from this responsibility, and you get it, subhanallah, from their question and how they are asking, and you have to remind them that, see, don't make deen of Allah as a play, as a joke, otherwise you are going to end up as a joke. Because that's how Allah the Almighty will tell you. Once you are asking something, ask it for the sake of Allah. To improve ourselves. To make our life even better. Because this deen is to improve my life. It's not to enforce Allah's command on me. It's to improve my life. In dunya and inshallah in the life hereafter, in akhirah as well. Bi-ithnillah.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salamu alaykum.
Khalis.
You just answered what I was going to say. I didn't have any money for the car.
Yeah.
I'm disabled. I would never have gotten to the masjid if I didn't have an automobile. Alhamdulillah. Please, brothers, make dua for me. Because I know about river. Law enforcement, writing tickets on cars. I worked on the subways. I give people tickets because that was my job. I took care of children, took care of my wife, my family, went to Hajj, alhamdulillah. But the river that I've experienced, even now, they call it a surcharge. You pay something, and they add more to it. That's a cert. That's river. And like the brother was saying, here in America, I was born here. Everything we do is dealing with this dunya with the riba, but like you said, Sheikh, our intention, our niyat, should be to improve ourselves and taqwa Allah, alhamdulillah. But Allah gave me this car right outside. I'm finished paying for it. Took 6 years. I gave him $1 to get this car because I didn't have any fulus. And they said, okay, I'll pay you monthly out of my disability check, blah, blah, blah. And they charged me almost double for the car. I would never have been to the master's praying, and I have witnesses that I make at least 5 prayers a day in the master's. Alhamdulillah. But I need to, I feel bad about it because I can't change it. This system. And also, the other question about the 4 math apps. We follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Nice,
but do we discard the math apps? That's my question.
Jazakallah khair. No, we respect opinions of ulama and madahib. And again, for example, as Sheikh pointed out to Nabeel, or let me point out to another issue, I don't follow Hanafi madhab 100%, but being or lived in Pakistan, I have a lot of like color of it of me. For example, in Salah, in Hanafi school of thought, there is no jama', really. Jama' means to combine. They have a conditional jama' that at the end of the time of Dhuhr and the beginning of Asr, you may perform Dhuhr and Asr 2 and 2. So it's not really jama' taqdeem or jama' ta'khir.
Jama' suri. Suri.
Okay.
They call it jama' suri.
Suri, okay. Means?
That means you pray Dhuhr in the end of the time of Dhuhr and the beginning of time of Asr, and Sunni, Assalamu alaikum wa sallam, now you make Asr. So this is jama'
suri. From Surya, Sheikh, or?
No. Not for Suri.
That's what I asked me is what.
Suri.
Okay.
Sada. Sada.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
What Quran is it there?
But this is against actually a hadith sahiha and sariha. So we should have jama'at taqdeem and jama'at akhir to combine early Dhuhr and Asr or late as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. And there are other examples even in other madahib, in which, for example, in Madhab al-Shafi'i, Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said awla mastum an-nisa, he took it as if you touch any woman, your wudu is nullified. And this is also not right. So we have it in all schools of thought. But doesn't mean we nullify or we reject school of thought completely. These opinions, ulama, they know it. And Ahlul Ilm, these opinions are familiar among them, that it's not really valid, or it's one alim or one imam, his opinion. And you can learn it again once you go through some alim and learning from him, or some institution, you will learn these stuff. Jazakumullah khair.
The
mushkil
is not in
Allah. Ah, jazakumullah khair. No, that is not allowed. That is not allowed. Especially when you have, as imma themselves, I won't even use the word taqleed because that is really a custom of jahiliyyah. ما وجدنا عليه آباءنا. We will do whatever our forefather used to do. This is we follow Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is one of the conditions of iman, ittiba' Rasul. It's obvious.
But some people have not, though. That's why I said some people think this is not how it's followed. He says because you shake it down. No.
Jazakallah. May Allah reward you. May Allah reward you.
Mind of the people.
Commentary
is some of us will keep our money in the banks, like the Bank of America, or whatever. Is this halal or lam or it's maqlu or what?
Let Sheikh Adli answer this. Why you are putting me on spot? Especially
on these very technical questions.
Bismillah.
Serious?
Yeah, no, I'm serious because you asked me to 2%, so that's okay.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I'm the least in knowledge here among the shuyukh, but if I've been forced to talk, I have no choice to talk. I would say the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, which is the meaning is درهم من الربا يأكله الرجل وهو يعلم أشد من 36 زنية, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. One dirham, a person devoted knowingly, worse than committing adultery or fornication 36 times. Besides this hadith, I would like to mention the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Help one another towards righteousness and good deed, and do not assist one another towards sin and disobedience of Allah. I want to let the brothers and the sisters, if we have sisters here, bank doesn't have money. Bank doesn't own money. Bank takes your money, his money, her money, it money, because frogs and dogs have money nowadays, more than me and you, okay? They inherit it from their owner. So they take the money of the people, and out of this money, now they're using it, part of it to lend the people and make percentage. And the Prophet ﷺ had cursed the person who gave the riba, received the riba, witnessed the riba. So by being given your money to sit in the bank, bank use it, now you are part of this haram. Now, if there is a necessity, like Brother Khalis was talking about buying car, necessity is various from person to person. وَالضَّرُورَةُ قَدَرْ بِقَدَرْهِ. There is a necessity, but you could not exceed the limits of necessity. So if you have no choice, if you try to tell me there is no choice except to put in your money in the bank, I disagree with you, but let's assume there is a necessity, you bought what is needed only in your account. So if you know your expenses per month, $5,000, why you have $50,000 there? So now you exceed the necessity, so you are not supposed to be. Somebody would say, so where I bought the money? Somebody will steal it. Still, أضعف الإيمان, you rent a safe deposit box and bought the money there. You can rent a safe deposit. You can buy a safe, put it in your house. Better than all these things, put your money in investment with Allah. He will give you for every dollar 10 and 700 and more. Put it in some Islamic school, printing Islamic books, in da'wah purpose, for a hospital. There is many ways. Why you have to keep the money for yourself? And he said, spend it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, it's no excuse for somebody to deal with riba and depositing a large amount of money beyond your needs and necessity in the bank. You are dealing with usury, you're part of the haram, you will be cursed, wal'iyadu billah. This is my personal opinion, I can be wrong. There is some who more learned sitting here, they can say no, but this is what I believe. What I meet Allah with this, and I'm responsible about my statement, and Allah knows best.
One thing I would like to add, very quickly, I hope and make dua that the communities here, Muslim communities, we start having our own banks, special community. It will be, subhanAllah, something really tremendous. That we loan out of those students who want to learn more, brothers who want to purchase houses, cars, and this will be for welfare as well. But for that, I would I'd like to put this suggestion for CIC also. If we start with a model, inshallah, we can, inshallah, make it even more, bismillah, successful. Jazakumullah.
It might not be legal in this country to have a bank that doesn't charge interest. It might not be legal.
In Iran, we have companies, you know, Islamic companies that provide. When I went to New Jersey, they have companies, Islamic companies, that provide money for those who like to buy houses.
Yeah,
and as brother said, there are
banks.
What you need,
there is a bank
that you actually
in
like.
Chicago, they want them.
And also the witchcraft.
Yeah.
They have letters free.
What is wrong for the no benefit? I mean, they cannot attach it.
They're not benefit free. I talked to them several times. So what they tell you to go get a mortgage from a bank, then they will tell you how much.
Brother, you're right.
I talked to them.
It's not. There is no Islamic bank even in Islamic countries.
Yes.
This is reality.
Sheikh Fozani wrote a book about this, and he mentioned this here, and it's in Arabic. He mentioned that all of the banks, they have to be backed by the original banking system. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So what you see up front is a lot of banking, it's what you see, but behind the scenes, but even if they don't charge you, they have to pay that river to the Yahoo, so it's still Ta'ala and Islam or otherwise.
Inshallah, we try it. Maybe one last question, and
yes,
we can go for the breakfast.
The suggestion I said that we have to go back to search our way out through the Sahaba. We need the better mind. That's only this problem.
We
can't if you don't go through them, we never get out of it. Just we need the better mind.
Last thing, Sheikh Abdi said that Ad-Darura Uqaddar Biqadariha. Okay, who can decide this is a necessity? Who?
You yourself.
Oh, no, not yourself. Because you yourself, you will decide this is a necessity because you like it.
So oh,
you
no.
Have to go with
fear of Allah,
with the rules, with the Islamic rules.
No.
Every one of us, you know, he can say this is a necessity for myself.
Yes, is this what I'm
but
saying?
But if he brings it to the Sharia, it will not be a necessity.
Akhi, okay.
God says in the Quran, chapter number 5, Surah Al-Ma'idah,
okay.
Ayah number, you know, verse number 3.
Okay.
He said,
go ahead. Okay.
So these are the lines. The guidelines.
This is true, Akhi. The Imam could not know my necessity. I know my necessity. But I have to have the ikhlas not to be shoving for fatwa. If the person has the ikhlas, now, as example, okay, I can walk, I take a bike, I can take a bus. In a big city in New York, you have the bus every 5 minutes. When you go to place in the south, the bus comes every half an hour. So if I could not go to my work, all right, unless I have a car, the issue here, why do you have to buy a brand new car? Get a reliable car for $3,000 and this is it. So I am the one who would determine, do I have a necessity or not? Not the scholar, but I can take my case to the scholar and tell me how far I can do with this. But still the scholar have to ask me, okay, can you rent the apartment? I said, no. Why not? He said, because I have 8 kids and they allow the max house here is 3 bedroom. What I can do? Now, if I did not buy a house, now the DSS will get in my case, take my children from me, giving them to the church. So to me, I have a necessity, which even the imam, if I don't explain my case to him, I can let my kids go from Islam to Christianity by the law of this country, and you could not do anything. So to me, became like the people who came from Somalia, when they moved here, refugees. They have, mashallah, 10, 15 kids. There is no apartment for these people. There is not even a house. Max a house, 5 bedroom with 3 bathrooms. And they still, nobody wants to give them a house. What's going to do? If these people, you did not get them emergency housing immediately, the DSS will come and take their children, give them the church.
Should we not say that first of all the Imam or the Mufti has to be smart?
Of course.
Like Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, go and intermingle with people, mix with them, and know the needs. They know what they need in their lives. So when they issue the fatwa, or the Mufti issues the fatwa,
will be coming
according to the reality.
Yes.
What people need.
We agree.
That's it.
We agree.
But still, who can decide this is a necessity?
I leave it to you. Okay, I leave it to you.
The one who intermingles with people.
Alhamdulillah. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Full burden, ya jama'a.
Yes,
Alhamdulillah. He gave us finished your life. And Alhamdulillah, and Allah bless you with the connection. But I say this. The Sahaba, radiallahu anhum, they are our way out. And we cannot get out if we ignore that way.
You're absolutely right.
So, inshallah, what we do, just please get to the masajid. I mean, you have the key to the net, you have the key to the... Inshallah, put this forward. We need Baitul Mal. Every masajid, they have to put money on it. We need Baitul Mal. That's Baitul Mal is going to solve many problems of masjid. But if we try to do that, we're going to end up always battle on the devil, battle without action. So we have to try to do action. Really, please, as long as Allah can give you life, please use this opportunity Allah gave to you to make this happen.
And as I told him in the beginning, he's responsible for something else.
Oh, please,
definitely. Keep it in mind. Full of ta'amayya.
Jazakumullah khaira. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. Please kindly stand for the breakfast, and it's going to be enough time. You can talk with the shuyukh. We have at least 5 of them here. You can intermingle with them, but allow them to get their plate first, please.